Hi guys, this is Lauren from RC Benchmark. Today I'm going to show you how to use our motor, propeller, and ESC database to help you find the most efficient propulsion system for your drone. So here we are on the RC Benchmark homepage. We're going to click on over to Database, and this will take you to the database landing page where we have some interesting information. First off is one of our most popular videos on how to increase your flight time. Then we have some top five lists, so our top five uploaders. Good job, guys. Our top five biggest propellers tested, top five biggest brushless motors tested, and our highest five thrust tested. And it looks like the highest one is 77 kgf. Nice. So moving back to the top, if you want to upload data to our database, you can register and create an account with us, log in when you're ready. If you want to check out the thrust stands and test stands that we offer, you can click over here. That'll bring you back to our homepage. And if you want to contact our sales team, you can click contact us over here. But if you're just here to check out motor, propeller, and ESC data, these are going to be your top four options up here. So we'll start with motors. And under each of these tabs is a list of all the pieces of equipment that we have fitting this description. So our motor list includes every motor with data uploaded to our database. So you can sort them however you like, by weight, shaft diameter, KV value, and by the number of magnetic poles. You can upload data or change the display units if you like. Under propellers, it's the same thing, so you can sort them by weight, diameter, pitch, or material. And finally, the same thing for ESCs, but you can sort by max current or BEC current. Now let's see what happens if we click on one of these ESCs. In this case, it's the Emax Beale Heli 80 amp. And if you scroll on this page, this includes data for all the tests we have uploaded with this particular ESC. So we have its specifications here. And then these are all the tests we have available. So it looks like there's 57 entries, so 57 tests total. Moving back to the top, if you're looking to refine data based on some specifics about a piece of equipment or certain performance specifics, that's where this test data tab comes in. And we have an awesome system where you can add filters to get exactly what you're looking for. So I'll take you through the example filter today. Let's say we want to build a long endurance quadcopter with a total weight of 2,000 grams. When flying at hover, without any motion, the total thrust generated by the four propellers must be equal to the equivalent force of 2 kgf. This means the hover thrust of each propeller is 0.5 kgf. Let's also assume we want the quad to be capable of generating twice the thrust for control authority, so 1 kgf. Finally, assume we're constrained to 5-inch propellers and a single motor configuration. We can apply our example filter, and that'll give us what we're looking for. So test done with only a single motor as opposed to coaxial. 5-inch propellers, we want to see tests done that reach at least 1 kgf. And we can add a column that shows the combined efficiency at 0.5 kgf of thrust. So we'll click apply example filter. And as you can see, it automatically puts all those things we asked for in there for us. And we'll go into more detail on that in our next video. But for now, we'll scroll down to the results. So there's 27 entries total, and you can see they sorted them by the highest efficiency in grams of force per watt. So we'll click on the top result here to see what we get. And so this gives you all the information about this test. So we have the components used. We have a description of the test settings. So the environment, the calibration standard that was used, rotor direction, RPM sensor was used, our RPM probe, ESC configuration, and we can also see that our series 1585 test stand was used for this test, and we can also see the test script that was used in case you want to replicate what they did. And finally, here's the plots with all the data. So we have pretty much any kind of data you would be looking for: rotation speed, thrust, torque, power, current, motor and ESC efficiency, propeller efficiency, and the overall propulsion system efficiency. So very handy stuff. And then we also have the raw data table down below. So as you can see, you can get a lot out of searching in this database, and it's all the better when designers and engineers upload their data. So please contribute to the database if you have tests you want to do or have already done. And if you want to know any information about the database, feel free to reach out to us or post in the comments. We love hearing your questions. So that's all I'm going to cover today, but in our next video, I'm going to cover a more detailed look at how to use the filters to get exactly what you're looking for, and also how to use the data provided to calculate your flight time. Thanks for watching.